Krishna's yours forever. And you can understand that when you decide, I am Krishna's. I am for Krishna. Krishna, let me be your instrument. Use me according to your wish. Is there any questions? Yes, from.
Thank you, Maharaj, for a wonderful class. As you are telling about ulterior motives, so some gross ulterior motives are there, person understands. But sometimes a person has certain way to look things, or he has some experience in his life so that his perceptions are different. So when he receives the message, there is certain block, whether this is right or wrong. So how we can understand that our motives are not ulterior motives, or our motives are ulterior motive which blocks us to get this knowledge, and how to transcend these ulterior motives, means even the subtle also, so that we can become good receptacle of the mercy.
Just be simple. So simple to be simple. Just want to serve. And do not have all kinds of schemes in order to fulfill your desires through your service. Yes? To serve. Yes? Radhe Shyam Prabhu, he wants water? Give him water. Radhe Shyam Prabhu, do you want water? I think he's ready to give. But if you're thinking, well, you know, if I give him water, then, you know, he may make me the vice president. And that's the ulterior motive. But if you just give him water because he wants water, then it's a servant. Yes? So we have all those ulterior motives. We should understand what they are, and we should not try to serve our ulterior motives. Like that example of the good dog and the bad dog, the divine and the demonic nature that is within us. We have both, all of us. We have the simple desire just to serve, to please. And we have another desire to be the enjoyer. So even when we're doing service, ulterior motives will definitely come into your mind until you're very purified. But with our intelligence, we understand, I don't want that. I'm not going to act for that. I'm going to pray to be free of that. And then we can become simple. That's what all these books and all these examples are for. To convince us not to want our own ulterior motives. But how many of them are in the mind? Countless. It's not either you have them or you don't. The path of bhakti is not for people only who don't. It's to teach people how to deal with it. And what we should really be desiring and how we should be desiring. And that we can make our decision today, at this moment. Does that make sense, what I said? Thank you. Yes, Prabhu.
Maharaj, talking about the children's education, I always am facing a lot of problem into that. As a parent, we always have a that type of a thinking in our mind that before the child comes to the teenage, because in Bombay, teenage, the boys are becoming so much completely contaminated with sex desire and all sorts of other contamination. So we have a desire in our heart that before my child comes to a teenage, he should be completely engrossed in Krishna's, in hearing, in chanting, in associating. That type of a desire, a sincere parent used to have it, so that at least from our side we feel that we have done our responsibility, then it is up to Krishna and them to decide what to go ahead. But now the problem that comes up is the child has been so much force and so much pressure is there because of the studies, so much subjects, so much studies, so much homework, and due to that reason he finds it extremely difficult to go to that path about Krishna consciousness in a serious note. And then we force him to do that, and he is having so many other commitments. There is so much pressure going on in the house, and due to that reason our relationship with the child becomes little bit strained. And we feel that because of that thing, our relationship will become strained, and in future it will be difficult for us to have that cordial relationship. So in that circumstances, what to do at this juncture? To give him more emphasis on Krishna consciousness, or to just pull on for his studies? Because this is really becoming a very complicated matter right now.
Tape recording of this question should be sent to all the parents. We are dealing with this subject actually. But in my opinion, in Prabhupada's opinion, yes, this particular type of educational system may program young people with an incredible amount of data, which they're going to forget 99% anyway. But it's not meant to give them good character or faith or happiness. The idea is the more data you have, the more you'll pass exams, the more you'll get good seats in colleges, the more money you'll make, and the more happy you'll get from that money. That's the whole system. But actually, most really intelligent parents who leaders of society and so forth, they don't even send their school to the system, their children to these systems. Some of the most of the wealthiest and most wealthiest men in this world were not even, they didn't even do good in that system in education. They didn't like it, they didn't do good in it. Some of them didn't even do it. So we are discussing, and it's my very, very, very strong opinion that our schools should have alternative systems that actually educate people so they're more learned, with good character, and with quality life by which they can become Krishna conscious. And there are systems like that. The only problem is the parents are just addicted to this, you know, just cramming data into their children's brains in the form of education and putting so much pressure. So you're asking my opinion I have given. But it's also Prabhupada's opinion. Oh, I sincerely believe there are systems that actually people who really know how to educate children, who really, really know how to educate children, they don't put such pressures on them. It's a very inferior form of education. If you learn a few things in a really, really suitable, pleasing, wonderful atmosphere, you'll remember that much more than 100 things in a suppressing atmosphere. Yes? You just learn it and learn it and learn it and cram it and cram it and cram it for the exam, and after the exam, it's gone. So what have you gained? A good grade, so you can be promoted. But how has that helped your life? What kind of system is this? Yes, education is very, very important for children, but if we want our children to have a quality of life, a Krishna conscious life, one of the biggest problems in India is young students committing suicide. It's a huge problem in India. Japan, America, almost like an epidemic. Students committing suicide because of the pressures of the parents. Somebody recently told me, here in India, one young student committed suicide. And in their note before they committed suicide, you know what they wrote? It's a true story. I can't mention names, but I know the names. I was just told this a few weeks ago. This young student committed suicide, and in their suicide note, which was like the last thought before death, they said, my prayer is I could become a ghost to haunt my teacher for the rest of eternity. You're laughing? If it was your child, you wouldn't be laughing. And if you were the teacher, you wouldn't be laughing either. But that's serious. The teacher just put so much pressure on the student. The student wanted to die just to haunt the teacher. It's not necessary. It's not that we're against this form of education. It's just not necessary. It doesn't really bring people, it doesn't make people saintly good people. You could learn the subjects better without all that pressure. Children should be happy. They should have time and energy to love Krishna, not just worry about the exam, the exam, the exam. For what? What's it going to do for you? It'll just promote you to get a better seat somewhere so you can do the same thing again, so you can make a lot of money. But I know billionaires who didn't do good in school at all. They have good karma. That's what Jagannath Mishra said to Sachi Mata. Jagannath Mishra said, our son is not going to study anymore. And Sachi Mata said, how is he going to get a good wife? And how is he going to make a living if he doesn't study properly? And Jagannath Mishra said, look, I've studied so much. I know so much shastra. I know so much everything. And there's no grains in our house. And look over there. That man over there, he does not know how to write a single letter of the alphabet. And yet, all the pundits are coming to beg alms from him. Yes. So education, even if you have it, it doesn't mean you're going to make it. In America, there are tens and thousands of PhDs who don't have a job. Some of them work at the petrol pumps. And the persons who own the petrol pumps in the oil industries, some of them never even graduated high school. And the PhDs are pumping their gas. for education. IIT, very nice. So many nice devotees. But for children, they should have quality life along with their education. And they'll actually do better. They'll learn more. They'll learn more both theoretically and practically. And there are more advanced techniques of education that simply have been proven to work better. And we want to introduce those to Gopal's garden if the parents just open their hearts beyond their own conditionings. But I'm going to end here so you don't have any opportunity to think of anything else. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.